What's happening, Panda Nation? Peter Von Panda here. I want to see if Beadmaker can really add a shine. So, Beadmaker is a paint sealant, and it's kind of pretty well known in the car detailing community for really creating some paint protectant and really adding some nice gloss and shine to paint work. Now, of course, on camera, it's always a little tough to demonstrate that and really kind of see it in the video, but what I wanted to do here is try to take an extreme case. Now, this is a good paint protectant if you are not a car dealer detailer and just want to add something to kind of give yourself some hydrophobic properties. Let water bead up and run off your car. But on the back of my car here, it might be a little hard to see. This rear bumper has kind of been sitting out in the sun. This car wasn't extremely well cared for prior. You can see here some really deep scratches and just how dry. Maybe I'll come on this the other side here. And dull it really is. You know, if you kind of go up here to the quarter panel, it's much shinier. You can see the reflection on it, but you can't see pretty much anything over here because of how bad this paint is. It's just been baking, oxidized. And what I wanted to do here was just take like half of this bumper and kind of hit it with some of the bead maker and just see if I can add some shine to this bumper. What I would like to do is do a full paint correction, really detail this up, but this is just going to be an extreme test of the bead maker and see if it works. Now, one of the things that I really love about the car detailing industry innovation is that a lot of these products now are coming in spray on applicators. And I'll be honest, that makes a huge difference because, you know, when I used to detail up my own car, what you'd have to do is get out carnauba wax and spread it around, and the paste kind of clumps up and you almost have to use a machine to get it off. And so spray on application just makes it so much more accessible to so many people. Now what I've done here is I've put a light mist on stuff. You're actually supposed to kind of atomize this as much as possible and get as much coverage as possible. And like you can see, I'm only doing it on this half of the bumper here. And then you're actually supposed to let it sit for a couple minutes to kind of soak in and adhere to whatever the underlying surface is. The other thing that's supposed to be really nice about this is that whether you wax or ceramic coat your car, or maybe you haven't done anything except clean it up and polish it, it's really kind of adheres to everything. And it's not just for exteriors of cars. You can use them on a lot of different stuff, but because it has a hardening agent or hardener in it of some sort, and I'm assuming it's air activated, when you let this cure for 8 hours or more, a lot of people are doing it overnight. I feel like anything that gets hard, you don't want to necessarily put on anything that's flexible, but I guess you can. So anyway, you're supposed to put this on here, let it kind of soak in for a couple minutes. Now I only have one type of microfiber towel here. It's a thin pile. So I'm just going to kind of smear it around, kind of rub it in a little bit here. It's down here on the plastic even. And just kind of gently moving it around. And then what I will do here is flip it over to the dry side and kind of polish it, which is kind of knocking down any of the high spots. And I'll tell you what, holy smokes, dude. Holy smokes. Even just running this towel here, I can tell you, man, holy smokes, it feels super smooth. And I will tell you, it is knocking the sun back at me. Pretty impressive on this part. You can see here how bad this panel was. These are some deep, deep scratches. You can feel them with my fingernails. Cracks even. Those aren't even scratches. Those are like impact cracks. Just showing you how dry this paint is. Now, it's maybe a little more visible down here on this plastic. You can absolutely see where it ended and the plastic is dried out over there. So it gives this a deeper, darker shine, which is nice. So it absolutely works on plastic. But even over here, it might be hard to see, but holy smokes, you can see the reflection now in it. And I mean, I can feel like the grit under there. This should have obviously been clayed and polished beforehand, but just over here, man, look at that. That is crazy. This bumper is in terrible, terrible shape. And I wouldn't say it looks great shape, but the immediate results here are pretty amazing. If I just swing over here, not sure how well this is gonna work, but I mean, if I get my towel really close, you can see the reflection. But man, and just feels like I'm running my hand on saran wrap. That is dry as a bone. And then as soon as you get over here, I mean, you can even see kind of the grass in the bumper on this side. Again, this is really hard to explain and show on camera, but I can feel right here in the transition where it's slippery and smooth. It feels like I've just applied a wax, and then right here, just dry and squeaky. Don't get any of that sound here. So it doesn't get any easier than that. And man, that really lifted up the side of the bumper. I feel like I'm gonna have to do that side just because now it looks a little lopsided. But before I do any more, like I said, I'm gonna do a full correction on this car and get it detailed up and make it look nice before I put anything on it, before I put the ceramic and the bead maker. But that is pretty that is awesome stuff. I think you want to lay on a pretty generous base coat the first time you use it, and then afterwards it's kind of more maintenance. But that is pretty awesome stuff. Bead maker, check it out. I'll put a link to the description. Peter Brown Panda out.